Hi friends, this is Madhvi Tumala and I am from Vyans Medical Academy. Today I am here to share some few information about the role which plays a major part in all living organisms called digestion. Guys, did you anyone guess the topic now which we are discussing now? It's digestion and absorption. Let me give a brief information about called digestion. Guys, do you know how food was digested and how digested food reabsorbs into our energy as body? Okay, friends, imagine that we went for a restaurant and we ordered some food items. In front of us, there are so many food items. In food, there are five components are present: carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, minerals, and roughages. In all five these components, roughages plays the basic main role component for digestion. Okay, let us know process of digestion. When the food it enters into our mouth, with the help of teeth, tongue, and saliva, the first step of digestion it takes place in the mouth. Let me know the information about teeth. The teeth are two types: temporary teeth and permanent teeth. The temporary teeth we can see at the age of 8 months to 6 years, and permanent teeth we can see at the age of 18 years to 25 years. And we can see the dental formula for temporary teeth: 2102 by 2102. The dental formula for permanent teeth is 2123 by 2123. The teeth is embedded in a socket of jaw bone. The type of teeth is teakodont. And the hardest part in our teeth is enamel. The enamel is made up of fluorine element. And let us know about saliva. The pH of saliva is 6.8. And the four types of salivary glands in mammals and three types in mammals. They are submaxillary gland, sublingual gland, and parotid gland. In submaxillary gland, 70% of saliva was secreted. And in sublingual gland, 5% of saliva was secreted. And in the parotid gland, 20% of saliva was secreted. And in these three types of glands, sublingual gland is the smallest gland in mammals. And with the help of teeth, the food was masticated and it converts into bolus. And with bolus, transfers into pharynx. And from the pharynx, it enters into the esopharynx. The process between pharynx to esopharynx, the process is called swallowing. And the food particles, it enters into the stomach. The stomach is divided into four parts: fundus, cardiac, body, and pylori. In the stomach, 80-90% of food was digested, and most of the proteins were digested in the stomach. And in liver, the weight of the liver is 1.2 to 1.5 kg in adults. Liver stores glycogen, vitamin A, D, K, and B12, etc. The liver is the largest exocrine gland in the mammals. And in liver, bile duct is present. The bile duct secretes bile juice. The bile juice which helps for digestion of fats. And the food particles, it enters into the duodenum. With the duodenum, it slips to the small intestine. The process between duodenum and small intestine, with the help of spectroscopy, it enters into the small intestine. In the small intestine, 20% of digestion mode takes place. And from the food, it enters into the large intestine. The large intestine, the water reabsorbs and it converts into energy. And the undigested food from the large intestine, it passes through the rectum and it's stored in the rectum. And in the rectum, undigested food gets stored and it comes out with the help of anus. Friends, for this complete digestion, which plays the basic role? Right, water plays the basic role for complete digestion. For the perfect and complete digestion, we must consume 6 to 7 liters of water daily. Suppose friends, if we won't take sufficient water to our body, what happens? Nothing guys, the digestion will be incomplete and we can cause some digestive disorders like jaundice, vomitings, diarrhea, constipation, and indigestion. Now, let me take digestion of food components. The digestion of carbohydrates, or most of the carbohydrates were digested in the mouth, and carbohydrates is converted into maltose plus sucrose plus lactose by the presence of amylase, and maltose is converted into glucose plus glucose by the presence of maltose, and sucrose is converted into glucose plus fructose by the presence of sucrase, and lactose is converted into glucose plus galactose by the presence of lactase. And digestion of fats. Most of the fats were digested in the liver, and fats is converted into emulsified fats by the presence of bile and bile salts. And emulsified fats is converted into triglycerides plus glycerol. And digestion of proteins. Digestion, most of the digestion of proteins were digested in the stomach. And trypsinogen is converted into trypsin. And chymotrypsinogen is converted into trimotrypsin. And protein plus prolactose plus pectose is converted into tripeptase plus dipeptase by the presence of trypsinogen, chymotrypsin and carbohydrates. And in the examination of 2018, the first question was asked, which of the following term describes human dentition? Thecodont, diphycodont and heterodont. Second question was, which of the following gastric cells indirectly help in erythropoiesis? And the answer was parietal cells. And friends, I hope you like the video. I wish you and the Viyans Medical Academy wishes you the best of luck for NEET examination.